another episode of Glaucoma Case Files here at NYU, here with John Williams and Manjool Shah. You know, a lot of variety in the types of patients that we see, obviously. And, like, one of the ones that we will see in glaucoma clinics are patients with diabetes, and it's not an NBG thing. Right. But they're being treated for the DME, and the topicals don't work, the intravitreal injections don't work, and then they get...
Steroids.
Yeah.
So tell me about this case.
So we know glaucoma docs love and hate steroids, right? Bane of our existence, rocking a hard place sometimes. And steroid-induced glaucoma is, you know, for one thing, it's a great disease for the MIGS surgeon, right? Because it's a true trabecular meshwork disease. Yeah. So this patient, interesting guy, really nice gentleman. He's had a couple intravitreal depot implants for DME, which really do a great job in controlling it. But of course, you can dance with the devil, you know.
It's so sure steroid implants.
Steroid implants. And sure enough, he started to get a steroid response. Interestingly, he responded really well to laser trabeculoplasty, which again, we know intrinsically works great on the angle, obviously, so it sort of makes sense, but there isn't great literature utilizing SLT for steroid-induced ocular hypertension. But it worked for him, and he was off meds. But he, sure enough, the other consequence of steroids is a cataract formation, right? So sure enough, he started to develop a cataract, his pressures were stabilized, and we thought this was an opportunity. So again, the benefit of canaloplasty in this individual, we know where we are. That eliminated catheter with the iTrack system really gives us the confidence. Again, his pressure was controlled. We just want to keep him that way, right?